Hello, and welcome to Opera in Brief, the show that summarizes operas for your convenience and entertainment. Today we will discuss one of Mozart's most famous operas, The Marriage of Figaro, which is based on the play which was a sequel to The Barber of Seville, upon which Rossini based his opera as well. Just as a refresher, in The Barber of Seville, Figaro the barber helps Count Almaviva marry Rosina, much to the chagrin of her guardian Dr. Bartolo, who intended to marry her with the help of the music teacher Bedelio. Now, 3 years later, much has changed. Act 1 opens in an empty room at Count Almaviva's estate, where Figaro and his fiancée Susanna have been hired as hand servants to the Count and Countess respectively. Susanna complains that she's been getting creepy looks from the Count, and she's sure he would like to exercise his right as Count on their wedding night, if you know what I mean. Figaro says, "Bring it on, Count," and they walk off stage to start scheming. Bartolo enters with his old housekeeper Marcellina, a woman to whom Figaro owes money. She says she intends to hold Figaro to the contract, according to which he should either pay her or marry her, thus preventing his marriage to Susanna. Bartolo, still angry at Figaro for helping Almaviva marry Rosina, agrees to help Marcellina. Bartolo leaves and Susanna enters. She calls Marcellina a bitter old maid trying to ruin her wedding, and Marcellina storms off in a huff. In walks Carabino, a young page boy who is just starting puberty and thus loves every woman, but especially the Countess. He's worried that the Count doesn't approve of his behavior and asks Susanna to put in a good word for him. Unfortunately, the Count barges in right then to mac on Susanna, so Carabino hides behind a chair. In walks Bedelio discussing Carabino, and the Count reenacts discovering Carabino with the gardener's daughter Barbarina, and in the process discovers Carabino once again with Susanna. A crowd of peasants charges in with Figaro to try and pressure Almaviva into executing the wedding. Almaviva dodges by saying he'd rather postpone so he can give a proper party, and also gives Carabino orders to join the local army regiment to get him away from the estate. End Act 1. Act 2 opens in a room with the Countess musing on her husband's infidelity. Susanna enters to help the Countess with her morning routine. Figaro enters and explains that they need to distract the Count in order to carry out the wedding without him. His plan is to arrange for the Count to meet Susanna that night in the garden, but to instead send Carabino dressed in women's clothing. He leaves and Carabino enters. They begin to size Carabino for dresses, and Susanna leaves to get a ribbon. They hear the Count coming, and Carabino hides in the closet. The Count notices that someone is in the closet, but the Countess tells him it's just Susanna trying on her wedding dress. Susanna quietly re-enters and hides. The Count, super suspicious by this point, leaves with the Countess to find something to pry the closet open with, meanwhile locking every door behind him so that no one can leave. Susanna helps Carabino out of the closet, and he jumps out of the window to escape while Susanna takes his place in the closet. The Count and Countess return, open the door, and, to both of their surprise, find Susanna rather than Carabino. Figaro enters again to ask to start the wedding, but the gardener enters to complain about the man who fell from the window breaking his flower pots. The Count knows it was Carabino, but Figaro takes credit. The gardener has proof it was Carabino, but Figaro dodges it. So close to victory, Bartolo, Bedelio, and Marcellina enter to bring charges against Figaro for his contract with Marcellina, and the Count postpones the wedding to investigate. End Act 2. Act 3 opens in the wedding hall. The Count, still confused, sees Susanna again, and she agrees to a rendezvous that night. Then he has the hearing with Figaro and Marcellina, and it is decided that Figaro must marry her. Figaro argues that he can't marry her without his parents' permission, as he is of noble birth, but unfortunately they only know that by the belongings and the birthmark he was found with as a baby.
Birthmark?
Marcellina asks. Yes, a birthmark right here on my...
Right arm?
Wait, how did you...
Oh my god, you're my son!
Ew!
And he's your father!
And everybody's like,
ugh!
And then she forgives his debt and tells him to marry Susanna, and Bartolo proposes to Marcellina in a fit of joy. Everyone leaves and the Countess enters, still pondering over her husband's lost love. She dictates a letter to Susanna, instructing the Count to meet her and return the pin included in the letter. A chorus of peasant girls enters offering flowers for the wedding, and Carabino is among them. The Count notices Carabino and is furious, but Carabino is saved by a sudden wedding proposal from Barbarina. Bada bing, bada boom, everyone gets married. End Act 3. Act 4 opens in the garden outside the estate where Susanna has agreed to meet the Count. Figaro sees that Barberina has lost the hairpin the Count told her to return to Susanna, and he is furious that Susanna had actually agreed to meet the Count. Susanna enters and hams it up, knowing that Figaro is angry and a little bitter that he still has such little faith in her. The Countess arrives in Susanna's clothes and is nearly outed by Carabino, but the Count sends him off when he arrives to mack on her. They exit flirting together. Susanna arrives in the Countess's clothes and sees Figaro, who immediately recognizes her and begins to mess with her too in return. Then enters the Count, who is furious to see his servant hitting on his wife and causes a scene, pulling almost everyone else on stage. The crowd begs him to forgive Figaro, but he refuses until his wife enters dressed as Susanna and exposes the whole ruse. Everyone laughs and he asks for forgiveness, and they decide to work out their problems with a night-long party and plenty of alcohol. End of opera.